So, at this point, we have seen that writing perfect assertions that cover all bugs can be pretty hard. But this shouldn't keep us from writing assertions that catch as many bugs as possible. And this is particularly useful in debugging. Since assertions are automated, they can check several executions of a function at once, actually all executions. However, they can also check large portions of data at the same time and all automated. What do I mean by large portions of data? Let me illustrate this by an example. Let's assume we want to implement a time class, a time that consists of hours, minutes, and seconds. And we want to use assertions to automatically check whether a time object is consistent. That is, whether the hours are in the right range, minutes are in the right range, and seconds are also in the right range. Here is our time class. We start with an initializer, or a constructor, that takes three arguments, the hour, the minute, and the seconds, with default values of 0 for each. And we assign these to individual attributes named hours, minutes, and seconds within a time object. Here's a number of inspector methods that give us access to the internal attributes, hours, minutes, and seconds. After adding inspector methods that give us the hours, the minutes, and the seconds, we now need a way to print out a time object. For this, Python provides a special method. It's called the REPR for representation method. It's an internal method with two underscores before and after. And what this thing does is this method is called whenever an object of the particular class is to be printed, and this returns a string representation of the object. So what does it do? We're using the string format method here, which takes a number of arguments and formats each of these arguments given to the format specification written here in that string. So, for instance, colon 2D prints the numerical argument here with two digits. Self minutes also comes in two digits. Self seconds also comes in two digits. This format is not perfect yet. We actually want leading zeros in here. And we want hours, minutes, and seconds separated by colons. So here's our string. First the hours, two digits, leading zero. Then the minutes, two digits, leading zero. And then the seconds, two digits, leading zeros. Let's try out how this works. I'm initializing a time object here, 13 hours, 0 minutes, 0 seconds. We're using a 24-hour clock here, and I'm printing this out. And printing this out should now invoke this wrapper method, which would automatically provide a nice string representation of our time. Let's run this whole thing, and we get nice representation, 13 hours, 0 minutes, and 0 seconds, 1 p.m. in the afternoon.